morning, children. Now, I will continue the third chapter, that is the National Movement, Part 2. I told you earlier, two demands. I think till now you must have learned all the demands points. Third one is administrative demands. Demand for Indianization of services through simultaneous Indian civil service examinations in England and earlier India. Earlier, exams were held only in England, so it was impossible for the Indians to go and give exams. Complete separation of executive and judiciary means judiciary should be totally separated from the executive. Spread of primary education among the masses. Improvement of police system to make it honest, efficient and popular. Wider employment of Indians in the higher grades of administrative service, because earlier the high posts were not given to the Indians. Civil rights. Civil rights means our fundamental rights should be defended. Removal of the restrictions imposed by the British government on the freedom of speech and press. Vernacular Press Act, I told you earlier. Abolition of Preventive Detention Act and restoration of individual liberties. Liberties means freedom. Our freedom should be maintained, and unnecessarily those who were detained by the Britishers, that should be abolished. Restoration to of assemble and to form associations also should be granted. Now, so many methods were adopted by them, just as they held meetings, delivered speeches, where so many types of resolutions were taken to perform their demands. Deputation of Indian traders were sent to England. Use of press to criticize government policy, that was a very good weapon in the hands of the Indians. They sent memorandums, means circulars, and petitions to the government officials and British Parliament. They used 3 P's, petition means continuously requesting them, then praying them, then if it was not heard, then protest. Then some of the points were there where they got some progress or achievements. They were arouse the feeling of one nation, train our Indians in the art of political work, exposed the true nature of the British rule in India, just as they only finalized the schemes on the paper, not amplified them. Pressurized the British government to introduce certain reforms, just as appointment of a police service commission, holding of ICS exams simultaneously in London and India, appointment of Welby Commission on Indian Expenditure. So all these points you have to learn as it is. Criticism also are there. Means in some of the fields, the Indian nationalists, they failed. What were they? Their methods were criticized as inadequate, means not proper. They failed to realize that the British and Indians' interests clashed with each other. Britain was using Indian resources to increase its wealth. What does it mean? That Britishers were doing whatever they wanted to increase their own wealth, not India's. They did not have a mass following because failed to draw the masses into the mainstream of the national movement. Means they were unable to mix up with the lower class or the lower middle class. That is why they failed. So thank you, children.